I have got the editorial of a very leading English daily Hindu of February 16, 2013. Honorable Defence Minister, in present day politics, this kind of expression is rarely used about a politician. It was used for you, and I wish to read that. When the UPA government chose Mr. Anthony as Defence Minister, the rationale was not that the man with a strong reputation for probity would be able to prevent corruption in defence purchases, but that he would act as a shining shield for the political establishment to deflect charges of wrongdoing. But a clean image is no guarantee for efficiency in governance. In spite of my very profound respect for you, Honourable the Defence Minister, the surrounding circumstances are so suspicious that I tend to agree with the kind of analysis which has been made in the editorial. Now, let me straight away put the first question. The issue is not of technical specification. The issue is not about the quality of the helicopter. The issue, simpliciter, is kickbacks in violation of the integrity clause and the terms of the contract. Today, two things are clearly admitted. The main company is owning up payment of kickbacks in the investigation. Who are the middlemen has become known. The only thing required to be known in India is who are the recipient who got the kickbacks. If that is the case, let me take from your statement five specific instances as to why you did not choose to act. Now, paragraph 20 to 24 of your statement says, of the Defence Ministry, that the first information about unethical dealings came to light in February 2012, paragraph 20. You write to the government, the embassy in Rome, please take information, they do not get it. My second query in this regard is very specific. Paragraph 26 of your statement says, in the light of Ministry of Foreign Affairs directing the embassy to approach the prosecutors in Italy, a formal request was made on July 16, 2012 to Naples prosecutors. What happened thereafter? The entire statement is silent thereafter. Why did not the government of India pursue the matter with the prosecutors in Naples in view of the enormity of the situation? That is my second question. I would like to have a very clear and categorical reply. My two colleagues, Prakash Javadekar and Mr. Chandan Mitra, have elaborated the matter. On 19 4 2012, April, nearly a year, one Mr. Edmund Allen of Gantens Limited writes to you. He sends an email to you containing many classified documents. May I ask you a question? Did you order a CBI investigation for how classified documents went to him? Or did you order a CBI investigation to know the veracity of the allegations made? A CBI investigation was ordered way back in 19-4-2012. And let me say, write to you, MOD had written on 19-4-12 to CBI and an enforcement director for necessary action, as Abhishek Verma and others were also being named in various media reports in connection. I'm sorry to take the names of the media I wish to take because they are required to be given the credit. The Indian Express reported a series of reports on this connection. The Times Now channel in March 2012 reported a series of reports on this, regardless of what the Congress member have an objection. They have done a great job in exposing this. They showed the agreement of Ganton as to how commission was offered. The second opportunity for you, what did the CBI do in terms of your report of the Defence Ministry in April 2012? What happened thereafter? Your ministry puts the CBI into action and you don't take any further follow-up action. Is there something really doubtful? The third occasion is, Honourable Minister, I would like to have a clarity from you. In terms of your own statement of the ministry, para 32, in November 2012, a letter is received in the MOD from the Director Income Tax Investigation regarding allegations against Indian possibly involved in the deal as middlemen. You had a third clear occasion nearly 5 months ago from the Income Tax Department that the matter requires serious scrutiny. Therefore, the MOD needs to step into action. Why action was not taken then and there? Therefore, there were five clear occasions, and the sixth was the great follow-up action done by my esteemed colleague Prakash Javadekar. We asked a question on 12th of January 2012. Let me read your reply, Honourable the Minister. On the request of Ministry of Defence, the Ministry of External Affairs has taken up the matter with the Government of Italy to get further detail. However, in the absence of any specific information, Government has not started any formal probe in this regard. Now you are telling to the Parliament, on 12th of December 2012, no formal probe, but in April 2012, you have asked CBI to undertake a probe. Income Tax Investigation Department is approaching your ministry. You tell your agency approach the prosecutors in Naples, in Italy. They file an application on July 16, 2012. Therefore, three parallel investigations are going: A, by the CBI, April 2012, by the Income Tax Investigation Department, November 2012, and your own formal application to the prosecutor on July 16. Therefore, there were three occasions, Honorable Home Minister, coupled with the very categorical questions. What made you say that no formal probe is needed in the absence of information? If so many leads were available, why did your department not initiate a formal probe? And if that is the case, how is it that when Mr. Orsi, the CEO, was arrested, suddenly your department starts into action? A team goes to Italy, a CBI team goes to Italy and comes with all the information. The CBI in a week's time returns and makes a formal statement. And let me read that formal statement of CBI. Two middlemen from their share of commission allegedly paid huge sums of money to several Indian nationals through Tunisia and Mauritius route in the garb of engineering contracts with two India-based companies. Who are these several Indians? I am making a quote from the formal note of the CBI pursuant to the registration of the plenary inquiry. Therefore, Honourable Defence Minister, regardless of my personal respect for you, the surrounding circumstances are too suspicious. Wear your integrity cover used as a shield, because someone, somewhere, was trying to save someone. And knowing India as we do in the last so many years, such a huge kickbacks could not have been paid only to Tyagi, a former air chief, or his very exotic names, cousins, Julie and Doska. There are other people involved, because CBI says several Indians. Honorable Defense Minister, we would be very grateful that if these specific queries of mine are pointedly responded to. The country wants, we want a proper probe, because Italy did not arrest Mr. Orsi overnight. The investigation was going for so long, and the country is not prepared to accept that in spite of your effort, you could not get the information, and when Mr. Orsi is arrested, you get everything in a week's time. This logic is no one is going to buy. I repeat, someone was trying to save someone because of some reasons. Therefore, we want a fair probe. Who have paid the money is too well known. Through whom the money came is also established. Who received the kickback in India is only the limited nature of inquiry. We demand that inquiry to be fair, time-bound, not to meet the fate as to what happened in Bofors. The government of India was available to save a gentleman at that point in time. Therefore, if you could not act in time, Mr. Defense Minister, now the entire record of your public life is under serious question and scrutiny. Assure a fair probe, assure a timely probe, assure this House that regardless of the stature of this recipient, they will not be spared, and it will ensure that regardless of the high connections they have, they will be caught, they will be prosecuted, because the company which has flouted the integrity clause will not be spared. These are my very specific query. I'll be grateful if you come with a specific response. Thank you, sir.